guys, welcome back. I hope you're all doing really well. So today I'm going to be doing a more chilled out kind of video. It's basically a everyday kind of makeup tutorial. So I've got all my products laid out in front of me, and it's basically stuff that I've been wearing quite a lot, like on the daily. So some things have changed, some things have not, but hey ho. I will also be doing a Q&A, so I'm going to be answering your questions as I do my makeup. So I'm actually kind of excited because I haven't done a video like this actually, so I'm really excited to answer your questions and show you guys what I've been loving lately. By the way, if you don't follow me on Snapchat, make sure to follow me on there, because I did go on Snapchat and ask you guys what kind of video you wanted to see, and this one won by far. Like, I gave you like an option to choose from, and this one won. Later on this week I will be posting a the car key makeup tutorial, but my sister's gonna do the voiceover, so I think that video is gonna be so fun. So make sure to subscribe if you're not already, to stay tuned for that. So yeah, I'm gonna stop rambling now and just jump straight into this video. I didn't realize I had an eyelash on my face that whole time, but it's a chilled out video. So I'm gonna answer the Snapchat questions first, because you guys did ask me questions on Instagram, but oh my god, you guys went all out on the questions. Oh my goodness, you guys are like the sweetest ever. So the first question on Snapchat is by Umeshika_X. Hi Umeshika, thanks for your question. I know you're always like on my Insta live and you're just like the sweetest thing ever, but one high-end product I can't live without would be, I don't know, one high-end that I can't live without. I would say it's my Urban Decay Naked Skin Concealer, because sometimes when I just go out, I just need that. By the way, I'm using the Soap and Glory Archery 2-in-1 Brow Filling Pencil in Dark Chocolate, and I'm filling my brows with this. And a drugstore product that I can't live without would definitely be the Maybelline Lash Sensational Mascara, because some days when I just don't wear makeup, I just put mascara on, and it's like the best mascara ever. Like, seriously, I recommend it to anyone. And yeah, so it would definitely be the Urban Decay Naked Skin Concealer and the Maybelline Lash Sensational. So Chaya XOX asks, would you rather live 100 years in the future or 100 years in the past? That's actually a really hard question. Would I live 100 years in the future or in the past? I would say in the future, because I'm always saying forget the past and look into the future, and I guess I would say the future. So Justine, I hope I'm saying that right, asked, what do you do if your foundation is too orange for you? What would I do if my foundation is too orange? I would just try to balance it out with concealer, or use my Body Shop lightening drops. But again, if you don't have that, I would use a concealer just to balance it out, and it kind of makes even. Don't know what the hell that noise is. Yeah, that's what I would do. Samira asked, if you had to pick one... Dude! This is what happens when you have siblings. Keep your calm. I don't know why, like, when I film and, like, I get so frustrated easily if like my lighting's not well, or like I'm just struggling with the filming space, or if someone's making noise, I get so annoyed. Like, it's so bad, and it's just how I am. Like, I do get annoyed. I'm not always like bubbly happily, like, even though I try to, but I get annoyed. It's actually kind of funny, to be honest. But yeah, Samira asked, if you had to pick, what's your favorite high-end makeup product? My favourite high-end makeup product would be the Naked Skin Concealer. Yeah, because that's one thing that I would wear on its own. But to be honest, I've been loving my Tarte Shape Tape Concealer, so it could be that. Yeah. Actually, no. Urban Decay Naked Skin Concealer, because that was my original love. Like, I still go back to it. And she said, how many siblings do you have? I have... gosh, I don't know how much time I've spent on my brows. I have 3 siblings. I've got my sister and my 2 younger brothers. Thanks for your question, Samira. Martina Hakim asks, hi Anushka, what type of eyeshadow look you prefer on an everyday basis? By the way, I love all your videos. You're so perfect and gorgeous. Love from Trinidad and Tobago. Martina, Oh my goodness, you're so far away. Oh, thank you so much, Martina. You're so sweet. What type of eyeshadow look do you prefer on an everyday basis? So I'm gonna show you in this video. I will show you like what kind of eyeshadow look I like on a daily basis. I've been wearing a lot of sparkle actually at the moment, but I'm not gonna do this in this video because I know that not everyone wears sparkle on a daily like I do. But yeah, I'm gonna show you one that you guys seen it so many times on in my tutorials, but I'll show you in this video. Thank you so much for your question, Martina. H. Telly asks, at what age did you start to get into makeup? I love you. I love you too. What age? I started to get into makeup, to be honest, since I was really young. If I can, I'll insert a picture of me having a full face of makeup like when I was 4, because my mum was really into makeup as well, and she put makeup on me on my birthday. And I have like this full-on fuchsia lips, and I'm like proper like posing, you know. And it's actually kind of funny, and I always keep it because it's so funny, because it just shows how like I've been always into makeup, like it's always been in me. I don't know why, like. And I did, don't get me wrong, like I did go through that phase where I did not know how to wear makeup. Like I had proper full-on cake face before. It was really bad actually. I need to like hurry up on my brows. This is so bad. So yeah, with this, I actually really love this brow pencil because it's super affordable, and it's actually very similar to the Anastasia Brow Wiz. So yeah, I've been always into makeup, but when I started to want to wear it like properly is when I was 12. And it was just eyeliner, and I remember my mom didn't want me to wear it at all, so I had to sneak it out and put eyeliner there, and it's so ugly, oh my goodness. And again, if I have a picture, I'll try and post it up. I'll put it here if I can, because I know there was pictures where I used to have like these black lines there. Tanisha.handa asks, what LA Girl concealer do you use? I don't have it with me now because all my makeup's in my room now. But I use the LA concealer in medium beige. And sometimes toffee, because toffee is like my actual skin tone, so sometimes I mix the two because medium beige is on the lighter side. Right now I'm using the Shape Tape concealer, and I'm just putting a bit on the back of my hand, and I'm gonna take a brush. This is a Morphe brush. It came with like the £30 set, and I'm just gonna carve my brows out. But thank you so much, Tanisha, for your question. I just need to carve this brow out. I always do this, especially because my brows are kind of messy at the moment, like because I don't go get them done anymore. They're definitely more on the messy side, and I definitely carve like on the top as well because I just feel like it cleans it up and it makes it look more sharp. You see that? It looks so much better like that. Panda.bear asked, any tips for minimizing pores when you're wearing foundation or dry skin? On dry skin, sorry. I moisturize before with oils and lotion, but I can always see dry patches and pores when the foundation is on. You have dry skin and you have pores, so maybe try like a pore filling. So for your pores, try to use like a good pore filling primer, and also try like a dermal roller. Dermal rollers are actually really good to like just overall smooth the skin and stuff like that. So I do have a video on that, by the way, guys, if you want to check that out. But yeah, try to use a pore filling primer. And then for the dry patches, just like at night time, well, try to exfoliate 2-3 times a week. Sometimes like try to put coconut oil like for like as a mask. Sometimes I do that. What else do I do for my dry patches? Because I used to have so many dry patches around my nose, and they're literally almost all gone. I definitely think that the exfoliating really helps. Try putting like a bunch of oils, not even just like before your makeup, try it like at night time so your skin's really nourished. And also drink so much water. Like I've been drinking so much water, and I feel like my skin has improved so much. But yeah, that's what I would recommend. So XO Alina asks, which pet is your favourite? Like, between all my pets, I don't have a favourite. I love them all equally. They're like my little babies. So I can't choose. I do really want a dog though. I really want a German Shepherd, but then I change my mind all the time. So I'll probably get like either a German Shepherd or like a staff, or American Bulldog. Like, I really want a massive dog. I just feel like they're so loving and I just can't live without a dog. I do have a dog already. It's like our family dog and we love her to bits. But I really want a massive dog. Oh, and I just used the L'Oreal Brow Artist Plumper. I really, really like this. And this is in the shade medium dark. I feel like I'm slouching a lot. Let me just bring the camera down. So brows are done. That's how I do my brows on daily. They're not perfect, obviously, but that's how I do them. But thanks so much for your question, Alina. MickeyMouse900 said, "Hi, Anushka, can't wait for the video. I really want to ask a question, but I couldn't think of one. But just wanted to say hi." Hi! That's okay if you don't have a question. Okay, so that's all the Snapchat questions. I'm now going to go on to Instagram. Let me start, like, doing my makeup. I don't know what the hell's going on with my face right now. So next up, I'm going to use the MAC Studio Conceal and Correct Duo. I've been wearing this a lot, and it's so funny. I've been wearing the yellow side. I never thought I would, but trust me when I say that this warms up the mouth area. And I wear a lot of it, but I really like it. It has this mustardy colour and it just adds warmth to the area, I just feel like. And I'm just going to blend this. So Scarlett London. Hi, Scarlett. Thank you so much for your question. She asked, any tips for a new YouTuber? I just started my channel, so need all the advice I can. So advice that I would give for, like, if you want to start your YouTube channel, like, the first thing ever is consistency. Like, you need to be dedicated to it. Like, if you want to bring it somewhere, if you want to go somewhere with it, even like if you want it to be something and you want to work towards that, like I do, like, I definitely want to make something out of YouTube. I would definitely say that consistency is so important. Like, you need to make sure that you're consistently uploading. If it's like once a week, I would ideally say, like, maybe at least two videos a week. I try to put three, but when I have exams, I probably put one or two, because during exam time, it's really difficult for me to do it. But I still upload, like, even whenever I had exams or anything like that, I always had one video up. And trust me, it's not easy, but it's really, really important, and it will definitely help you out. Another thing is, like, I watch your video, Scarlett, and, like, your setup and everything is so nice. Like, it's even better than my setup. Like, I just have a wall. So you definitely have that side covered. Like, you've got good lighting. But by the way, guys, check out Scarlett London. She's amazing. She's so lovely and she's so sweet to me. I'll leave a link to her channel in the info box. Another thing that I would say, I look really awkward, like, I look like I got turmeric on my face. Also, definitely do videos that you really enjoy doing, because then it won't, like, feel like you're doing a job or anything. Like, I honestly genuinely like doing my videos, and it doesn't ever feel like a job. That's why I get on my way to always upload, because I really, really like it. And sometimes I kind of sacrifice, I would say, my uni work and then go upload a video. And it's not a good thing, but it's really bad, actually. I shouldn't be doing that. My friends are always telling me, like, you need to revise and not, like, post a video. And I'm just like, no, I want to post a video. That's what I'm trying to say. Like, if you really enjoy doing what you do, like, on YouTube, and doing videos that you really enjoy uploading, then it will just come easy to you. And if you're starting and you don't have all the equipment, just use a phone and daylight. Seriously, that's more than enough. And iPhone cameras, and, like, cameras these days are have good quality anyways. And just put yourself in front of a big window and just film whatever you want to. And yeah, and I would definitely say consistency is key. If you consistently upload, you will see that it will come. And it will be slow. Like, it's really slow, to be honest. Like, for me, it's been really slow. For some people, it isn't. But it will come. Like, if you really, really, really want it, it will be there. So you will get there. So that's what I meant. So yeah, those are the little tips I would give. 30_GJ asked, do you have any plans in the future? I don't even know. That's a really tough question, you know. By the way, I'm using the LA Girl Pro Coverage Foundation in tan. So my plans for the future, I would say, is to finish uni, definitely. And then after that, I don't know what the hell I'm going to do. I don't even know. I actually don't know what I want to do. I don't know why, but I really want to make my own business. And I really hope that YouTube works out for me. If not, then that's fine. But it would definitely be my dream job. Because it's just so fun and I genuinely love it. I might make my own business. And I think that's it. I think that's what I really want to do. Just make my own business. I do so much research about it. And I always say it. And I just know I'm going to do it because I know I'm going to work for it. And you know, that's the mindset you need to have. You can't just keep... This is the thing with YouTube as well. I get so many people that's like, oh, I want to do your channel. Like, should I do it? And I'm just like, just do it. Just upload it. Just upload it. Don't do it tomorrow. Don't do it next week. Don't do it next year. Just do it today. If you don't have like the equipment, just get your phone. Go in front of a window and just upload. Because if you don't start, you're not going to go anywhere. So you might as well, if you want to do it, just do it. And I feel like making a business is the same example. Like, I just need to jump into it and do it. If I truly believe in it and I truly know that I'm going to work hard for it, it will happen. And that's with everything in life, I feel like. Imashika asked another question on Instagram. She said, a country you really want to travel to. Where do I want to go? I really want to travel to America. Like, I can't believe I haven't been to America yet. I really want to travel to, like, the islands like Bora Bora. The Maldives, like, places like that. Oh my goodness, that would be such a dream. And I really want to go... Dubai. I really want to go to Dubai. And I want to go back to Mauritius. Like, I haven't been in years and I really want to go with my mom and my sister and everything and my boyfriend as well because he's never been. And I want to go to his country as well, which is Guadeloupe. It's kind of near like Haiti and all that. I love this foundation. Can I just say that? Like, this foundation is so good. If you haven't tried it, definitely try it. It's definitely more on the luminous side. So if you have like oily skin, you need to be a bit careful with it, but I just really love how it just makes my skin look so glowy. But you know how you can kind of see the yellow? Like, I need to cover that a bit more. Let's go on to the next question. Joanne asked, what would you like to be doing in 5 years? So, like I said, hopefully I want to make my own business, and if it does work out, I want to have kids. I want to have kids by 26. Like, I really want kids. I really want children. Like, it's so bad. Like, but I'm obviously not in the place to be having kids right now. I'm at uni and I want to be very financially stable if you want to have kids. And I want to do things. Like, I want to do things before. Like, if I could have one right now, I would. But I want to be able to go travel because I haven't been doing any traveling for years. I want to do like activities and like sports stuff, like, you know, like aqua sports in like other countries, like I don't know how to say this name, but it's SHXUTI asked, what are you doing at uni? And I get asked this question so many times, but I'm studying economics and accounting. Don't really like the economics part, to be honest, but Shahima asked, what inspired you to do makeup? Well, I always wanted to do makeup. I feel like I always had it in me, and it was actually watching a lot of YouTube videos. Like, YouTube was my TV. Like, it was literally what I would watch every day, all day long. And obviously my boyfriend, he kept seeing that I was watching videos and he was just like, why don't you just do your own channel? And I never had thought about it. Like, I never thought of doing a channel myself. And I was like, oh my god, like, I never thought of doing that. Like, should I do it? And he was just like, just do it. And then I got my camera and I started to film. My boyfriend did really like encourage me to do YouTube because he could see that I already loved makeup, and I used to bother him so much about makeup. Like, in France, when we were together there, I used to like bug him all the time to go into Sephora and things like that. And he knows I just love makeup. So he was just like, just do it. And that's how it got into my mind. Like, I never thought myself to do a channel. It was so weird. So yeah, in terms of makeup, I just wanted to do it. Like, it's always like I always wanted to do makeup, but in terms of like my channel, it was definitely my boyfriend who kind of gave me the idea to start one, and I just did it. That's the thing, like I just did it. At the beginning I was like, oh yeah, maybe, and like 3 months later it was like, why are you waiting? And I would just do it, and I was like, okay, I'll do it. Okay, Rasha Seed asks, what is the best high-end foundation to buy if I want light coverage? Light coverage. I'm just trying to think, because all my foundations are not light coverage. My camera stopped recording. I saw Makeup by Shayla wear the Bobbi Brown skin foundation, and it looks so good on her. It's definitely good for like combination skin, and like it's like skin, literally, like it's kind of like sheer coverage, so I would definitely recommend that to you, because I don't know of any other like foundations that are light that you could wear. I'm just trying to think right now. No, I would say definitely try the Bobbi Brown skin foundation. Name underscore Adam asks, what drugstore foundations do you love from the UK and high end? So definitely this one, it's one of my favorites, and the Milani 2-in-1 foundation is really, really, really good as well. And also the Kiko one, the Universal Fit Hydrating one, is really good, and I will have a review on it soon. It's actually really good. It does have like a few downsides, but it's actually like when I wear it, I get like so many compliments on my skin, and I'm just like, whoa, like I just wore a different foundation. So that's another good one. And then in terms of high end, it would definitely be Too Faced, Born This Way, or NARS Sheer Glow. Thanks so much for your question, Naima. KGonza345 is, what is the last lie you told? Last lie I told. Can I please? I think it was something like, you know, like when I'm out, my sister asks, can you go to McDonald's? And she knew I was going to McDonald's. And she's like, can you get me McDonald's on your way home? And I was just like, I don't have money. But I've obviously bought some already. But it's not good to lie. I try not to lie, okay? I lie about little things. HBA.Shankar asks, what would you let a fan do your makeup? I would definitely let anyone... 2 seconds. I would definitely let a fan do my makeup. Like, I don't like to say word saying fan. Like, I'll definitely let one of you guys do my makeup. But I'm actually quite a picky when people do my makeup. I'm one of those people, and it's just that whenever I've had experience with someone else doing my makeup, it just looks completely really, it just looks really bad. Like, I'm not even joking, it doesn't even look okay. It's actually really bad. I'm putting my Tarte Shape Tape concealer, but I would definitely let you guys do my makeup just for the fun of it, you know. The reason why I'm so picky is like the people who've done my makeup are makeup artists, and they just did it so bad, and I'm just like, really? Is this presentable to you? Once someone did my makeup, I kid you not, like I went into training for work. I kid you not, I went to training and they did my makeup and I literally looked like a tangerine. The shades were like 5 shades darker. Someone said to me, oh my god, girl, you look like you're gonna go Essex, and I'm just like, really? Really, I just really, really love this concealer. I look really dodgy right now, and I really like to put it on my lids as well, because I really I think it helps to like make a really clean canvas for my eyeshadow to go onto, and it's so good. Like, you guys need to try this this concealer. It's available on QVC UK if you live in the UK, but they don't have all the shades, which is kind of annoying. But I'm so happy, like. I didn't think there was going to be a better concealer out there better than the Urban Decay concealer, and it's actually right up there with it. It's sometimes a little bit better, to be honest. And I really like to just bring it in the inner corner here, because I get darker down there, like because of the shadow, so I just bring it there just to brighten it up. Oh, and another thing I've been doing is putting concealer here. But I did it wrong. I actually been doing it underneath my foundation. And it helps to prevent the creasing on my smile lines. Yeah, so I would definitely let one of you guys do my makeup. I really want to do meet and greet one day, because it's different talking to you guys online and actually meeting you guys in real life. Priya just asked, what are you passionate about, and what motivates you to keep doing what you're passionate about? So to be honest, the thing that I'm most passionate about at the moment is my makeup and this channel. Like, I'm so dedicated to it. And I feel like what motivated me is because the thing that motivates me is just because I just naturally like it. I don't really need, oh, I'm just gonna sweat my mouth area. I've been doing this a lot lately. Like with whatever's left on the sponge, I just like press it around my mouth area. So yeah, that's what I'm really, really passionate about. Like I just have a true love for it, just to like teach you guys to do makeup and be like creative, really, just creating like good content for you guys. And yeah, I think that's what keeps me motivated, because I just really, really enjoy it. And that's what the thing is when you're doing something that you love, you're constantly motivated. So don't get me wrong, sometimes I just feel so unmotivated, and then it's just like for a day, and then like that day would go and then it'll just be gone. It's so weird. But yeah. Okay, can you see like how that Benai banana powder made my skin look so smooth and flawless? Like I just, this is like my ride or die. This is my go-to setting powder. Thank you so much for your question, Priya. Juhi X asks, what's the best way to get flawless makeup for those who have a dark mouth area? Basically like me. To be honest, I don't have the darkest. I've seen some people with that with really, really dark. And to be honest, I would just use a corrector. Just use a really full coverage corrector. Like this one, this MAC one is very full coverage. Or wear like the LA Girl Pro correctors. Those are so good. And I don't know if you watched a video makeup tutorial that I did on my mum's best friend Samantha. She has really, really dark pigmentation under her eyes. And I used the... I can't speak. I used the LA Girl Pro corrector in orange, and that literally just helped to cover it so well. So try that. And I wouldn't use the yellow one if you're like darker than me. Try use an orange one, I would say. When you've like blended the corrector, let it sit for a second and then put your foundation on top. And you want to use like a full coverage foundation if you are going to correct, because I feel like if you're going to use colors like orange, it will come through if you're using a light coverage foundation. I feel like when I do chilled back videos, I get into this like very like chilled zen state. I'm actually quite a zen person in real life. Like sometimes I get hyper, only sometimes. Thanks so much for your question, Juhi. So Agnithad89 asks, what's your biggest phobia? My biggest phobia is teeth. Oh my god, my biggest phobia is teeth. It actually is. I have so many nightmares about teeth. I feel like I'm just chatting away and I'm forgetting about my face right now. Because like I've set my base with the Benai banana powder. I don't need to put anything else. So what I'm going to use this ColourPop shadow, which I really, really love. It's in Elixir. And I'm going to grab a buffing brush. This might not be an everyday look for some of you, but I just really love these type of colours. Yeah, so my biggest phobia is bloody teeth. Like, you guys, I don't know if you guys know, but I'm really self-conscious about my teeth because they're so rotten and I'm getting stains on every single front one. And I had like a hole in my tooth, and like I've had so many fillings that if you look in my mouth, there's so many damn fillings. Like, I'm not... And to be honest, my dentist said that these teeth aren't going to end up falling, so because they're already cracking, and I would need implants. So I'm trying to save for implants, because I feel like if I had implants for my teeth, I would smile so much more, because every time I smile, I'm just like... And it's so annoying. I just want to be able to have a nice smile. And I never used to have that gap. I can't believe I wore braces for 3 years to get implants at the end. But to be honest, it's my fault as well. I eat so much sugar and they always give me a moral at the dentist. And it's also the jaw as well. Like, I have such a huge phobia. Like, when I'm yawning, I get so scared that my jaw will lock open. Or, like, in my dreams, I get dreams where, like, my jaw's constantly closing and it's not stopping, and like my teeth are crushing because it's consistently like going down. That was like my worst nightmare, I kid you not. Like, I've even had one where like the dentist took all my bloody teeth out and couldn't put them back in, and I had no numbing thing. Bones, like when people break their bones, ugh, that's really bad. Don't know if you guys watched The Orphan. Oh my lord, when she put her arm in the thing and broke her arm like that, oh my god, I swear, I was like, and not a lot of things get me like this, and that definitely was a moment where I was just like freaked out. So I just like bring it out like as my transition colour, and just take your time blending. Don't rush it. If you rush it, you're gonna get harsh lines. I really like this brush. This is one of my favourite brushes, apart of the Mange set that I got, but they don't sell it anymore. I did update my links for my eBay and Amazon brushes down below because some of them weren't working, so I did update them, so hopefully it's one in one of those sets, but I will try and find a dupe for this brush because it's so good. Okay, so I'm done with this shade right now, and I'm going to go on to the Colourpop Fairfax colour. I think this was a limited edition one, but it's like a nice dark browny colour. These Colourpop shadows have like a moody texture, so I feel like sometimes I need to get like a more denser brush. Okay, so yeah, that teeth are my biggest phobia, I would say. I slouch so much, it's kind of bad. A slipper! Naju_AAR asks, how do you find colours to suit your skin tone? It's very similar to mine and I struggle a lot. Thank you, love you. I love you too, honey. I would say, what would I say? How do I find my skin tone? Do you know what? Foundation.com is really good because it gave me, I put some foundations that I wore and it actually gives me the right colours I actually wear in other foundations. So it's kind of nice. Sometimes it's wrong though, to be honest. But it's like, it gives you a good guide, especially if there's a foundation that has so many colours and you have no idea what to go for. And foundation's really good. And I always say that I go onto Google, look for swatches, and then I also go onto YouTube, and people who do reviews on that particular shade, I see how it looks on their skin tone and if they're like a similar skin tone to me. I really like this brush. This is the Sigma Buff and Blend E39 brush. You can get this on their website, and I do have a coupon code that's available in the info box. And if you're going in store and swatching, swatch like a few colours, and if it's on the counter, ask them to like put it on your face, maybe like choose your two shades, do half and half, walk back and look, because sometimes when you like step back and actually look at your colour, you can definitely see the difference in tone, like especially if you're doing half-half, so I would definitely say that. Okay, Ruby Kurana 11 asks, hello, tips for starting out with eyeshadow application and best brushes to use, please. So with eyeshadow application, like definitely wear primer. So my primers are always like concealers. Then always use your skin tone color shadow or like a powder to set the base. So definitely set your base, and that's just gonna really help with blending. And then just use like, a lot of my brushes come from Amazon and eBay. Really good, because I see Desi Perkins were using like the brush one. It's like, I think it's the MAC 135 or 137. But yeah, you can definitely get like Real Technique brushes, things like that. I feel like with eyeshadow blending, it's better to have a few brushes rather than just one or two. So Turlika, I hope I'm saying that right. So what are the best lip colors for dark skin? Oh my god, I'm going to show you guys a really nice colour for dark skin afterwards that I've been wearing on a daily since I got it. But so stuff like MAC Persistence or Kylie Jenner Lip Kitten, Brown Sugar, Colourpop Ziggy, Colourpop Lovebug, no, Lovebug's quite dark, Ziggy Daydream. Those are two nice Colourpop colours. Those are all really nice for dark skin. I am Nina, aka Nina. Nina's my friend. What's it like having a job, being a student and doing YouTube? I rate you. She's the sweetest person ever. Oh my god. If you guys want me to do a video with my friend Zahara and Nina, where like who knows me better, like we was talking about who we should do, like the who knows me better tag. If you guys want to see that video, let me know. But Nina, I don't even know how I do it. It's hard, and she knows because I always complain to her how busy I am. My planner definitely helps. I always have my like to-do list for every day, and sometimes I actually put makeup on so I don't go to sleep. So I revise, I do the work that I have to do, and I know that I won't sleep because I hate sleeping with makeup. But thanks for your question, Nina. You're so sweet. I love you. Precious_illusionart. Have you ever had times where you're low in confidence about anything, and how did you overcome it if you have been? Oh, there are times where I'm low in confidence. Trust me that. Like, I just feel like everyone goes through it. I get low in confidence about my weight sometimes, and my face. And my teeth, actually. Those are, like, the two things where I feel, like, really low about. Like, my teeth a lot, because I just feel like they're not that nice, to be honest. And then my weight's getting a bit better, actually. And I feel like it's because I've been drinking so much more water. How do I overcome it? I'm just like, do you know what? Sometimes social media gets me down about my weight, because I'm always seeing these fit girls everywhere, and I'm just like, bloody hell, like, my body ain't like that. And then I tell myself, like, they only show you stuff that you guys want to see. And it's also like, I work on a makeup counter, and some girls are so pretty. Like, they come to the counter and I'm doing their makeup and I'm just like, oh my god, you look so amazing and your skin's amazing. And then they're like, no, I don't like it, I've got so much of this, I've got so much. And they have their own like issues, like their own features that they feel so conscious about. And I just feel like it's the same for everyone, and that's what I tell myself. Like, everyone has those things that they're so self-conscious about. No one's bloody perfect. And you know what? I'd rather stay like the way I am and, you know, just be true about it. Like, I'm not perfect. I've got love handles. You need to see my bloody love handles. And I'm just like, that's what I tell myself. Like, not everyone, it has their own insecurities, and you might see the most good looking model out there. Like, she looks perfect, she looks amazing, but she would have her own insecurities. And that, trust me, it's true. Like, everyone has their own insecurities. And yeah, and sometimes when I feel down, I just go put makeup and it just makes me feel good again, to be honest. And I think that's it, really. That's how I get over my insecurities. It happens to me a lot. I always go to my sister, I'm like, I feel so fat, and I'm just like, who gives a crap that I'm fat? Who said it's not okay to be fat? But you're like, I just say, like, I have my own features that are unique to me, and they may not be perfect, but it makes me. So I know it's hard, and I know with social media it's really hard as well. That's why on my social media, I try to, even on my channel, I try to post as much as I can, like, bare face and my PJs on Snapchat, like, because that's how I am most of the time. Like, I don't always have lashes. Like, people who wear masks and they got their full eye makeup on, I'm just like, really? Since when do you wear a bloody mask with your eye makeup on? And full on lipstick. That's my mum coming down. And seriously, if you do have insecurities, just like, I don't know, just find a good out of it. It's nothing bad. I've got stretch marks. Who cares? That means I've got a bit of a jiggly jiggly in my bum bum. That sounds so freaking wrong. So thanks so much for your question, precious_illusion. This is the MAC Mineralized Bronzer that's starting to get a dent in it. I just really love this. It's just so... Look at that. This is one of my favourite brushes. This is this Sephora Powder 48 brush. It's more on the orangey side, I have to say, but I just really like it. I don't care. It really adds warmth to my skin. Okay, next question. Rami0508 asks, your face looks flawless. What's your skincare routine and how do you get rid of pimples? Thank you so much, Rami. That's so sweet. I would say drinking water has definitely helped my skin. I have to say that. Like, I've been drinking so much water, and it looks so much better. And I just make sure that I try to keep my skincare as simple as possible. I like to use more natural oils sometimes, like almond oil, coconut oil, And then I've been loving the Nip and Fab shots lately, especially the glycolic one, because it literally just helped my skin smooth, because I get really hard bumps on my skin, like little tiny bumps that are called milia, and it's really hard to get rid of and they stay there for like ages. But I use like when I use that glycolic fix one, and I actually used to use the Nip and Fab glycolic fix cleanser, I think it was, and that really helped to smooth my skin, and it kind of like resurfaced my skin, and I feel like that shot did the exact same thing. And I just used a lot of Bobbi Brown skincare because I just feel like her skincare is so good. If I were to recommend one thing from Bobbi Brown, would be their treatment lotion, amazing, and their extra repair balm if you are dry skin, because it's very very moisturizing. I've been protecting my skin more, and because I've been using all these glycolic brightening products on my face, like the Glam Glow brightening mask, that's amazing. You need to make sure that you have SPF on your skin. I feel like because those products are taking surfaces off your skin, like layers of your skin, to resurface it, like you need to protect it from the sun, and it's also going to prevent wrinkles, have SPF as well. So that's my bronzer done. I just really love it. Like, it looks more on the orange side. Well, not too orange. Like, in real life, in camera it does, but it just looks like my skin. I do bring it down my neck as well. So yeah, those are the things that I've been using on my skin. If you guys want to see an updated skin routine, I'll be happy to do that for you guys. But I really want to try, because I've been using quite a lot of high-end stuff on my skin, I want to go get and try some more, like, drugstore, like the Garnier Moisture stuff. Gershin Quoz _ asked, I have super straight brows and big cheeks, so I want to arc my brows, please help me. You have a face like me, honey. I would say grow your brows out to the fullest, like let them grow for like 2-3 months. I don't know, it's gonna be a struggle, but that's what I did. Grow them out so bad, because I used to have like straight thin eyebrows because I used to over pluck them so much. I'm not gonna do eyeliner, I can't bothered. I did eyeliner the other day and it looked kind of nice, but most of the time, to be honest, I don't wear eyeliner on a daily. So I'm just going to do my mascara. I always curl my lashes. I grow them to the fullest using the Lash Sensational Mascara in Intense Black. And then try and shape them yourself. Get a wax strip, like face wax strips, and this is what I do. I cut the edge so like it comes to the border of the wax. And I kind of go like that with the wax. And then go like that. And it will create your arc. And then try and tweeze, or maybe just go to a threading place, but tell them be super careful, and tell them like try and do your upper bit, and then tell them just to do your arc bit, and that will hopefully help. N_Childers asks, what's the best product to use to set makeup that is a reasonable price? To set makeup, Mario Badescu facial spray is really good. It's like £7 for a massive bottle. NYX Dewy Setting Spray, or the matte one, whichever you prefer. Oh, and the W7 Banana Dreams Powder. Definitely would recommend that. Ahmed_Kana asks, where do you work? I love your videos. Thank you so much. I work in, well, I don't know, I work in Southwest London area. Aliza.Khan asks, when's my birthday? My birthday is on the 26th of June, 1995. And I'm gonna be 22 soon. Faria_Pommy asks, will you introduce us to your boyfriend? I will, when he wants to. I actually want to make a French channel with him, because my boyfriend's French, you guys don't know, we met in France. But I really want to make a channel with him, like a couple's channel. But he did say when I reach 100,000 subscribers on this channel, he will do a video with me, and he better do that. I know he will, but he's just really shy, and because his English is not perfect, I think that's why as well. And we speak in French together, so I don't know how that would work out, but I will figure it out. KGonza345 asks, what is your favourite store to shop at? I get really excited to go Primark or like Beauty Base. Sparkle_Nam asks, how is your skin so gooey always in makeup tutorials? Gooey, that's a new word, I love it. I don't know, I just use really good moisturizers, setting spray, like moisturizers. I use like dewy foundations. I also really exfoliate my skin like 2-3 times a week, just to make sure like my skin's nice and smooth and plump. But thanks so much, that's actually, I'm gonna take that as a compliment, because I just love gooey, dewy makeup, like dewy skin. I love my Smashbox Primer Water, I feel like that really helps as well. She also asked any suggestions and advice to me. I've started a makeup account and plan on doing YouTube, but the thing stopping me is that I don't own a good quality camera. To be honest, you don't even need one. Like, in the beginning, just use your phone. If you've got like a good phone, like an iPhone or anything, or just get like a used camera on eBay. I did a video where I vlogged with my phone and the quality was just fine. Ganu Priya asked, any scary encounter with people? Not really. Actually, I have had a few, actually. Tu fais quoi? Tu crois que je t'entends pas? Il est bien ce écharpe.
Avec qui tu
Moi aussi j'en veux un. Il est où? You look.
£6.50 it was.
Je parle, ben je fais mes vidéos et ils m'ont demandé des questions, je réponds.
De quoi?
Je fais un Q&A.
Un quoi?
Q&A.
C'est quoi ça?
Ben je réponds aux questions. So I'm going to use this EX1 blush as like my go-to blusher for some reason, and it might look paler, but I just love the peachiness of it, and it's called Pretty in Peach. I just love peachy colours, especially where I know on my lips as well. Look how pretty that is. Why are you laughing at me? I think I may have put a little bit too much. My brother's had like really bad ones. Where he like runs into people, like a bunch of guys like grouped up in hoodies and like in nighttime, because he always goes for his shortcuts for some reason. I've had one where like I was outside at night and these like little bunch of little kids came up to me, and like I was wearing my big hoodie, so you couldn't really necessarily see my face, and he came like right in front of me like that, and he was like, can I have your phone? And I was just like, no. And he's like, why? And then I was like, because I ain't got credit. Which I obviously did, but I'm just like, I don't have credit. And he's like, are you racist? And oh my god, I'm just like, my patience, I was so annoyed. This is why I freaking hate my area. Look at that nice glow. I might put a bit more actually. I always mix the two of these ones. But I'm sure I've had in others, but I can't think of them.
Yeah, there's one time I was going to work. Some like random old guy just like held my hand. And I was like, what the hell is happening?
He held your hand?
Yeah, he wanted help to cross the street.
Did you help him then?
Yeah, and he didn't say anything though. I was like, huh?
Aww. That's so sad. Some old people, they have no one to take care of them.
Yeah.
Okay, my skin's done. Let me just put some setting spray. I'm using my Smashbox Primer Water. On to the next question. Airani underscore Patel asked us, how much money do you get from YouTube depending on the number of views? So I think it's like $1 per 1,000 views. Mrs. Sonia 1B asked, how tall are you? The one beauty product you take to Desert Island, do you use false lashes? What's your nighttime skincare routine? Favorite hair product? Hashtag so many questions. wait 2 seconds, let me just set my face. Because my battery's running out. Okay, so how tall are you? I'm 1.66 meters. I don't know what that is in feet. What's the one beauty product you take to Desert Island? Maybe, if it was a desert island, probably Smashbox Primer Water to cool me down from the heat. Do you use false lashes? Only sometimes, because I just like the way it looks. What's your nighttime skincare routine? Literally, my nighttime skincare routine at the moment is Nip and Fab Glycolic Shot or like Bobbi Brown Treatment Lotion, and then Bobbi Brown Hydrating Eye Cream, or like the Clinique Eye Balm, and then I use the Origins Nighttime Cream, the Rejuvenating one, or the Bobbi Brown Nighttime Cream, Intense Hydrating Eye Cream. But like I said, I use a lot of high-end stuff on my skin because I really want to take care of my skin, but I will go into looking at more affordable skincare. And favourite hair product, almond oil, as you guys know, or coconut oil. Thanks for your question, Sonia. Jay Joanda asks, when you first started YouTube, did you ever feel awkward posting videos into fear of people at your school seeing them and confronting you, making fun of you? You're like that.
I just don't like being on camera.
Yeah, but when I went to do a video on Antoine, you're like, oh, he's gonna go to school and get bullied.
Yeah, we would.
But I was gonna do cool scar makeup on him. Why would he get bullied about that?
No, scar makeup's fine.
But
you were like, oh, gonna put like some weird mascara.
No, I don't. You're such a liar. This is what I mean. Oh my god, you're such a liar. I told you I'm gonna do skull makeup, and he's like, no, people are gonna bully him. putting you on the spot. And then we got into a huge fight because he was insulting me. And then he said to me, oh, you're just doing it to get the views. And I was like, what? You're such a dickhead.
You didn't say the skull thing.
No, I was going to do a skull. No, skull. Yeah. Like a proper full on skull, like with the black background so it looks like his head's floating. You didn't listen to me.
That would have been cool. But you didn't say that.
I did say that. What else would I do? Clown makeup on him? Princess?
Yeah, that's what I thought.
No, why would I do that? He's a boy.
Why don't you tell me?
Oh my god. This is the arguments we get into, guys. By the way, on my lips, I'm going to use the Black Up Makeup Crayon Jumbo Matte Pencil in 22M. It's like my go-to lip colour at the moment. And I have to sharpen it because I've been using it so much. Oh, that's so bad. My sharpener just broke the whole pencil. This is why I don't like. The thing is about lip products, I just feel like they have to be twisty up ones. Because when you sharpen them, you're wasting so much product. And this was expensive and that whole thing came. I just sharpened it and the whole thing broke off. Like, what the hell? And it's supposed to be a high end. I love the colour, but seriously, that's such a letdown. And I feel like everyone should be like that. Who cares what people say about you? Seriously. Who cares? Most of the time, people will just say things behind your back, trust me. Because they ain't got nothing better to do than say it behind your back. And it's just pure jealousy. Just do you, like, do your own thing, like. Move, I think Skin Face Beauty said this somewhere, on some quote, and it's just like, move in silence. Just do your own thing, don't tell no one. When you're successful, you're gonna see, because you'll see, don't worry. And yes, I did feel very, very, very awkward in my first video. You should go watch it. Like, I looked like an idiot and the lighting was terrible. Have you watched my first video?
Yeah, sure.
You don't even watch my videos. Thanks for the support. But yeah, I actually managed to answer all of your questions. I had so much fun doing this video. Like, if you guys want me to do more of these in the future, maybe not, like, in the near future, but maybe later on when I reach, like, maybe 50,000 subscribers. But yeah, I think that's the end of this video. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to hit the subscribe button if you're new, because I'm going to have my sister do my voiceover in the next video for the khaki makeup tutorial. I can't wait to do that and get that up for you guys. And also make sure to hit the little grey bell button. So if you, I know like YouTube has been messed up lately, but if you hit that bell button, you'll literally get like a notification when I upload, like through like email or on your phone or something like that. But if you guys want to like be there right when I upload, you can just hit that bell button. Make sure to hit the thumbs up button if you did like this type of video. Thank you again so much for your like all your support and like all the questions you guys sent me. And yeah, I think that's it. I love you guys and I will see you next time. Bye.